Soap operas.
Yeah, I guess you could say that.
Old and the Beautiful, and was I on that show? You were Candy?
Oh, okay. I have no idea. Okay, yeah, I started out in soap operas on Bold and Beautiful. I think it was Young and the Restless. I won some kind of soap opera contest out of college, and so that's the one that I remember. I think I maybe guest starred on Bold and Beautiful. Yeah. So I was never on in soaps very long, maybe 2 or 3 episodes total in my career.
Yeah, you were Robin on Young and the Restless.
Oh, okay, great.
I didn't have this week course here.
Wonderful.
So, you know.
I know. Someone the other day was like, "Yeah, I watched The Guest, and you were great in it." I was like, "I've never seen that movie." Can you tell I don't watch things that I'm in? So just, you know, started doing school plays, and when I was younger, I really enjoyed doing that after school, and went to school for theater, and moved to LA, and just started in soaps, and then guest starring a lot until The Flash. So that's kind of my career trajectory.
Well, then you did The Game.
I did do that. Yes. I do remember that.
And do you think that was like what got you kind of noticed for The Flash?
I don't think so. No, I don't think so. That was probably one of my longer recurring stints on television. But I don't think people really knew me from The Game. I think I just happened to be in the right audition for the right role at the right time. If you're asking me about Flash,
And how were you a fan of the comic books of Flash? Did you know anything about it before?
No, I didn't know anything about the Flash. I'd never read the comic books. I knew of the Flash, but I grew up more just Batman and Superman. Yeah, so something I had to familiarize myself with.
And so tell us a little bit about the audition process you went through, because that's, I mean, you're like a great character on the show. I mean, you're like, there's so many, you know, women and men and young girls that like look up to you and your character and how you've grown. So tell us a little bit about the process of you know, getting this role.
Audition came in just like any other. I was pretty excited about it. I remember my manager calling and he was like, "This is the one." He was like, "This is your role to take." And this was maybe December of 2013. And I went in, met with the director, David Nutter, who's the king of pilots. Did what I thought was a pretty terrible audition. I couldn't remember my lines. And that was that. I went home, I went back to Texas for Christmas and didn't really hear anything until January. They called me back in to do a chemistry read with Grant Gustin. And then within a couple days, I had the job.
That's because the chemistry is amazing.
Oh, well, thank you. Yeah, it's always nice when you can have an audition with an actor, especially the lead actor. There's a opportunity, like you said, to show casting directors and directors that you guys have a chemistry, and that's something you can't do when you're sitting down with just a reader. So I was really fortunate that I got to read with Grant, and that, you know, immediately we had a working chemistry.
So everybody's seen The Flash, I'm guessing. So that makes sense. Woo! Any events at my store on Tuesday nights, because that's the only show that we watch in real time. It's like, shh, everyone stop. But through the show, you started out as a character that was kind of just like, oh yeah, you know, Barry likes me, and here's Eddie, and now you're...
Thanks.
You did. It was like you were there. But then, what's great is that we've seen you grow, and we've seen you develop into what you always were on the show, but it's like we've grown with you, and we see now that you're this strong woman who's so smart and so talented.
So
integral to the team.
I've said this before, you know, I think it's important to show characters, especially women, growing on television. So often we get frustrated, like, why isn't she strong from, you know, season 1, episode 1? I want to see a strong woman right now. Well, that's just not true of anyone, women included. You know, I feel like I'm a strong woman, but you know, it took me years to get here. I didn't just start being a strong woman. I had to, you know, find older strong women to look up to. And so that's the thing I love about Iris, is that she's grown over the last couple of seasons and hopefully will continue to grow. She should be, you know, an inspiration to girls that, you know, you'll find your way. Don't worry. You know, you'll find your way.
That's what I meant. I wasn't saying that you
were
not.
No, I know.
But it's been really, it's so enjoyable to watch you and develop and really have a strong screen presence in there, and it's, everybody's rooting for you, and you're so integral to the team with Cisco. I mean, it's got to be like the funnest group to work with in the world.
It is. It's really fun. I think we're unusually lucky in that sense. I think we're all young and energetic and passionate and excited still by this show. And so, you know, we care about it. We care about the dialogue. We care about the story and the characters. And we work really hard to continue to make it better. And so, you know, we, you know, we'll come up with banter and just continually try and make it better and massage it to make it better and better and better. So yeah, it is it's a fun job to have.
And it really, really does show. How fun was it to do the Earth 2 episode?
Really fun. It was really fun. You know, I think in one episode we got to see Iris be everything we wanted her to be. You know, badass, you know, in a relationship with Barry. I guess the only thing was not having, you know, watching her father die. But it was... Other than that, spoiler alert, no, Earth 2 was really, really fun. I think I really enjoyed playing her as a cop, too. I don't know, I love any time they are like, you want a gun? I'm like, yes! All the guns, give me all the guns. I'm from Texas, so. Yeah.
So, your relationship with Joe on the show, mm-hmm. your dad,
yeah.
is amazing. He's an amazing character. But one of the things I love is that, you know, you're just seeing women on TV and they're like, they're the one bringing the food out and they're the one that's cooking. And it's usually him. And so
yeah.
how does that come about?
You know, I don't know who started that, but I like to think it was a female director. I remember, you know, and why I'm always advocating for diversity in television in every aspect, and the casting and directors and producers. You know, I think there was one scene where we were shooting in the West House dining room, and, you know, we started with, oh, we'll have Iris, you know, bring something out from the kitchen. And she was like, oh, wait, let's have this joke instead. And it's sometimes it takes a woman to think about the status quo and be like, no, let's not do that. You know, let's not continually, you know, perpetuate a stereotype. So yeah, I like that we continue to try and do that on our show. And I think that's because of the diverse roles we have created on the show, not just in casting, but behind the scenes. You know, we continually have African-American directors, and a lot of female directors come in and direct our show. And that's unusual for an action show to, you know, have 3 and 4 and 5 women directors come in and do a really good job. I mean, you want to talk about a great episode, Earth 2, the first episode of Earth 2 was directed by Millicent Shelton, a black woman, and it's one of my favorite episodes. I mean, so, yeah, I think diversity is really important in every aspect on television.
So that's like that, and I... Also, if you want to start lining up for questions, we'll take those in a bit. So the microphone's over here. I never know when they move things on. So how lucky do you feel to be on this show? Because it's gotten such great reception. I mean, it's an amazing show.
Super lucky. I mean, I'm always continually humbled, even going into season 3. I mean, it feels like yesterday I was just a hungry, starving actress living in LA, hoping for a job. And so I always have that kind of in the back of my head, knowing that this could be taken from me at any moment. So I'm really grateful. I'm grateful that I can come to conventions in Baltimore and people will show up and listen to me talk. I'm terribly boring when I don't have a script. So I'm really, really blessed to be in this position. And you know, I wanted to be a part of a job that would help change the future of television, and just being in this role, I feel like I've had that opportunity, just watching the climate change in television and seeing more Black women, you know, be leading ladies and ingenues. It's really, I feel proud to even be a part of that.
And you should. And one of the great things about the Flash, the show, it's like every single episode is like, seems like it's you know, should be the season finale. You can't do that. This is like the third episode.
I think that's the trick, and our producers have said very early on, don't save anything. You know, don't save the big idea for the finale. Let's do it now. We'll think of a bigger idea.
Yeah.
And that's kind of a smart way to create television. You can't save your big ideas. Shoot the big idea, we'll come up with a bigger one.
So, and next season, I know you can't say too much about it, mm-hmm. but we know it's Flashpoint.
Yeah.
It's going to be crazy. I can hardly wait. In my shop, we sold a lot of Flashpoint. We sold a lot of Flash.
Yeah.
Everybody's a huge fan. They all say hi.
Hello. What's the name of the show?
It's All Yeah Comics, Muncie, Indiana.
All Yeah?
All Yeah.
All Yeah Comics.
Yeah. Woo! No, you would come see us. Next season, can we? I know you can't say much, but can we see more of this? You know, Iris taking control and just being badass.
We say that on television, so I'm pretty sure that's an okay word.
Just pretend it's a bus.
Yeah, I think so. I'm trying to think what I can say without getting fired.
It's on Tuesdays.
You can always expect to see more of Iris, you know, in Star Labs, helping Team Flash. I'm always advocating for more of her at Picture News. We can see her in a reporter role. But yeah, you see a lot more of Iris kind of being a part of the team and helping in her own way, which I really like. There's Flashpoint, there's some really, really cool villains coming up this season, and our big bad is going to be pretty dope.
So, how excited are you about the whole Supergirl joining your universe?
Yeah, great, yeah. I think the fans love the crossovers, and so it provides more opportunity for us to cross over now that they're on the same network, and you know, they're in the same city as us in Vancouver, so it just provides more opportunity for us to make great television for you, so we gladly welcome it.
And strong woman.
Yes. Melissa's an incredible woman, actually, so
yes.
I'm really hoping that their show does great on the CW, so please, viewership matters, tune in, watch Supergirl, and watch The Flash, too.
Yes, absolutely. All right, first question.
Hello, my name is DeWolf. I'm representing Geeky TV on YouTube. And being a Black woman in television, I wanted to know, had there been any quote-unquote challenges that you would face taking on a character that is traditionally white and red-haired character?
Challenges. I don't think there are challenges in the character specifically, because I never approached her as like, I'm a Black woman and I'm going to play her as a white woman, or she's a white woman and I have, you know, I didn't ever approach it in that way. I just approached her as a character, and I always say Iris is more than her skin color. So whoever steps into the role of Iris, whether she's white, black, green, blue, purple, that's not what she is about. It's about her character and her strength of character. And so I've always just relied on the script. Everything else, everything you're seeing physically, that's just my shell. Hopefully you like it. If you don't, I'm going to tell you. That's what you're going to get.
I definitely like it. We definitely appreciate seeing you playing Iris. It's definitely been a joy to watch. And so, one other question.
Yeah.
And a lot of people that I know want to know, what is your guilty pleasure food?
Oh, girl. Where you want to start?
Exactly.
Cheeses. Chicken. Love the cheeses. Love all the cheeses. And chips.
Chips, what kind of chips?
I love just plain salty, crispy. I like ruffled chips. There's these chips in Canada that I can only find in Canada. I can no longer buy them. They just cannot be brought into my home. Because I will tear a bag of chips up. Like, yeah.
Well, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. You want to borrow my mic?
Are there going to be more emotional scenes, like the runaway dinosaur scene in season 3, or like it's going to be more action-based?
That's a great question. It's a lot of action so far. I personally haven't shot any real emotional scenes yet. We're shooting episode 6 right now. And I'm trying to think, these last 6 episodes, I don't know that I've shed a tear. So things are pleasant in Central City. Just a lot of crime fighting, you know, the huge. Yeah, but you know, we always love a good, heartfelt, emotional family scene, so I'm sure they're coming. So yeah, I mean, I would keep your tissues nearby for sure. Thank you. You're so cute.
Top that now.
Hi.
Hi, my name is Antonio Colon. I just want to say I am an absolute fan of your acting performance.
Oh,
I think the scenes in which, you know, you portray, like, the familiar relationships with, you know, Jesse Martin and Grant Gustin, like, honestly, probably my favorite parts of the show, like, emotionally touching. And so with that, what's it like to get to work with such incredible talent, in a sense, and to kind of bring that reality of, like, real relationships to television in a superhero show?
It's great. You know, I have a lot of scenes with Grant and Jesse, and they're usually, you know, heartfelt and deep, and it's working with such talented actors. It's helped me step my game up over the last 2 seasons. I feel like, you know, every time I get to do a nice meaty scene with either of them, my game is elevated. So I think, you know, by the time the show is over and I'm moving on to my next project, I feel like, you know, I'm going through my own boot camp here on The Flash, learning to do my own stunts. And even just as an actor, you know, the people around me that I work with, you know, they help me step my game up. Like, I can't come to set and not be on point, because Grant and Jesse will out-act me, you know?
Well, I can't agree with that. But yeah, thank you for putting on such an amazing performance and for being here.
Thank you.
Hello, my name's Winona.
Hi.
So I've been, you know, you follow a storyline. So did Iris graduate from her grad school degree?
Girl.
Woo!
But it kind of disappeared.
I know. Let's just say she did. Yay! Graduation party. It's on you. You can throw it.
My name is Harrison Bennett.
Hi, Harrison.
I'm just wondering if there's going to be, like, Justice League, like how in the comics there was, in the cartoon movie where it's going to be Superman, Hal Jordan,
right.
Wonder Woman.
Right. That I don't know. I don't think there's any plans for that, to be honest. I know that would be really cool if we had some Easter eggs kind of about that.
Or is it
that
just classified? Like, we can't know.
Listen. I know. I just really don't think that's in the plans, as far as I know. But, you know, they don't tell me anything, so it could be, and I just don't know.
Boo-hoo.
I know. So you just have to live with Easter eggs.
Well, The Flash is such a strong character, and you have such a strong cast. It's like, to bring anybody else in, it might be a little bit of overkill.
I think that's the thing, too, is we've found, you know, we have such strong characters in the series regulars that we want to tell their stories. The more characters we bring in, you know, it becomes a little bit claustrophobic. It's hard to give everyone a great storyline if you have so many characters. So, hi.